In this video, I'm going to show you live how to transfer Bitcoin from Coinbase to Binance, coming up right now. Welcome back, Satoshi Scopers. Alan again here. If you're new to this channel and you want to learn more about investing, trading, or anything else related to cryptocurrency, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss out on anything. So if you've watched my previous videos on how to buy your first Bitcoin through Coinbase, you have probably got your first Bitcoin ready to invest in your altcoin. If you don't, however, I've got a link in the description for you that you can go and check out and sign up with the Coinbase. And now that you have your Binance account set up and ready to deposit your first Bitcoin into it, we can go to Coinbase and buy some Bitcoin as a first step. I'm just going to buy $50. Press buy now, confirm buy, and it's confirmed. So go to the dashboard, and now the second step is to go to your Binance account, log in to the main page, click on funds, balances. It will come to this deposits and withdrawal page here, where you can see I have some funds here from my recurring trades. But now we're going to find the BTC wallet. So the first thing I do is type in BTC. This reduces the number of wallet you are able to click on and make a mistake. It's just my own way of doing things, but you don't have to do it. However, one important note that I must tell you is that two different wallets from two different coins cannot be compatible with each other. You can't use a Bitcoin wallet with an Ethereum wallet, or even in this case, Super Bitcoin, whatever that is. You can't transfer Bitcoin to Ethereum or Ethereum to Bitcoin. Your funds will be lost. So make sure to use the same wallet when you're transferring between two different wallets. And now that we have got that out of the way, let's make sure it's BTC and Bitcoin here before clicking deposit. Once you clicked on deposit, this page will pop up for you. So you can either highlight this and press Control C, or right click and press copy, or you can just press copy address. And that's the easiest and most sure way, because it says success there. So you've copied the address now. You can go to Coinbase now and click on accounts. And you can see you have money in your BTC wallet. So we want to send this. So press send and paste the address in. Control V or right click and paste. And make sure, very important, that there's no space at the end or at the start of the letters, and also the first two and the last two numbers or letters to match. That's the four letters that I always make sure, as every time you transfer, make sure they match. So here is 13 and ends with RE. So just double check it. 13 RE. So yes, that matches. So that's all good. And I want to send max. And you can make a note here. So the note I'll make is Bitcoin tutorial. Continue. And here you can see, as the last step before confirming, you must enter in a two-step verification code. So this is that two-factor that I've talked about previously. You got to make sure to use this. It's very important, because if your computer gets hacked, they still need to have access to your phone to be able to get the code. This code changes every 5 or 10 seconds. So they need both. Whereas if you don't have this activated, there's a possibility that they could hack your account and withdraw your money. So now I'll put in the code, and the code here is, and then press confirm. As you can see, the transfer is now in the pending stage, which hopefully will become successful. But if you want to find out more information, just click on here and click on the to address. A new page will pop up. And if you scroll down here, you can see it's the one and only transfer that has been made on this wallet. So you can see it's 0 out of 6 confirmations. What this means is that 0 out of 6 blocks have passed. So each block for Bitcoin takes roughly around 10 minutes. So 6 blocks times 10 minutes gives you 60 minutes, which is an hour. So it can take roughly an hour for your Bitcoin to be transferred from Coinbase to your Binance account. However, for smaller amounts like this, you know, $50, $100, it may require less blocks. It could be 2 or 3, but you don't know this until you go on Binance. So I'm just gonna give this 30 minutes and then come back to the Binance page here, the deposit page that we were on, and refresh it to see if the Bitcoin has arrived. So now I have waited the 30 minutes and let's refresh the page. So I have refreshed the page and you can see here that the balance has come into the Binance wallet. So that means it was successful. And now that the Bitcoin has arrived in your account, you can go ahead and purchase your first altcoin on Binance. So make sure to stick around because in the next video, I'm gonna show you how to make all these different types of orders, whether it be market orders, limit orders, or a stop order. I'll explain to you and do some live examples on how to buy and sell so that you don't make the mistake yourself later. So to summarize, I just wanna reiterate an important note I made earlier. Make sure when you're transferring your Bitcoin, you must transfer that into another Bitcoin wallet. You cannot swap them around and transfer Bitcoin to Ethereum or Ethereum to Litecoin. That's a sure way to lose your money. So make sure it's the same wallet. And secondly, make sure the address is the same from start to finish. And you can check the first two and the last two, and if they're the same, you should be all right. So if you want me to do a different live example on transferring your Bitcoin to a cold wallet or even another exchange, just let me know in the comments section below. Thanks a lot for checking out this video. If you found it useful, just hit that like button and let me know. And always remember to follow the sats.